Yeah, the students whose names are on this hit list just found out last night that their names were, in fact, on the list. But today, they still don't know who's responsible for making the list, which is, of course, giving them cause for great concern.
Glenn Lucota got a call around 9:30 Tuesday night. It was a short yet terrifying conversation.
My principal called me and said that I was on a hit list, but that's all he told us.
They didn't give us much information. That was part of the problem.
Penny Woolery's son, Cody, was also on the hit list, which was discovered by another student on an internet chat room. After police were notified, a search of the student's home turned up no weapons.
I know the kids don't always keep things that you want them to see out in the open. They hide it.
The superintendent of Laurel Highlands told us this morning the hit list was a hoax and the student is now suspended, but he would not identify that student.
I just think it's ridiculous that the school wouldn't tell us who it is.
It's unclear how many students were on the list. The superintendent told us it was students along with the principal and another faculty member whose names were on the list. Both Cody and Glenn stayed home from school today.
I might just not go for the rest of the week and try to find out more information before I go, because this is my life, and I don't feel like dying anytime soon.
I'm going to have to keep sending him to school and hope for the best time to watch out behind you. It scares you to death. It really does.
Now, one of the parents we spoke with today says the school district tells her that they will file charges against the student. Reporting in Uniontown, Fayette County, Jake Ploger, Channel 4 Action News.